Assalamu alaikum and hi. Our topic is about epithelial repair and regeneration in the uterine cervix.
Reparative changes is changes in cells that occurs due to injury from external stimulus. While regeneration is natural process of replacing the damaged cells, tissues, organs, and even entire body parts, regeneration is actually one of the process of repairing the cells.
The cause of reparative change. The mucosal epithelium may be damaged, causing inflammation, dead tummy, delivery, surgery, or even radiation. First, it is important to know about patient history. Check if patient have radiation therapy, chemotherapy, or even use IUCD, because this might give different interpretation to body style protein. Okay, this is how we report reparative cell in the body style protein.
The prominent features of reparative changes are anisonucleosis, where some of the nucleus size is normal and some is enlarged, but not more than 2 times. The nucleoli is visible and chromatin is pale. In the reparative state, squamous cell appear as cohesive. This is due to the ability of the squamous cell to maintain the polarity between the neighbor cell. Hence, it appear like a streaming appearance, like a school of fish or pool-like structure. Increased mitotic activity or the appearance of mitotic figure indicate regeneration, where the survived damaged squamous cell dividing to replace the lost squamous cell and damaged tissue. Because reparative always happen after inflammation, inflammation features also present in the case of reparative, where perinucleus halos and the nucleus enlargement can be seen.
Why it is important? Many characteristic patterns of reparative in cells can be important clues to a diagnosis. Repair is a challenging analysis and a significant source of false positive interpretations in cervical cytology. The identification in smears is important as they can often mimic low cell, high cell, non-keratinizing SCC, and adenocarcinoma. As mentioned before, repair is a challenging diagnosis and has contributed to a significant amount of false positive interpretations in cervical cytology. The distinction of reparative changes from squamous intraepitheliations or invasive carcinoma has been identified as a significant source of false positive cytologic diagnosis. In the study that Stutz has mentioned in his article, the overall false positive rate was 1,700 of 12,715, equivalent to 13.4%. Among the false positive diagnoses, hyoscine and adenocarcinoma were the most common interpretations, while hyoscine and squamous cell carcinoma less common. The consequences of being misdiagnosed, since misclassification is most common in hyoscine or carcinoma, this can potentially result in significant patient harm. Most patients will require colposcopy and biopsy and could even undergo a diagnostic excisional procedure. Moreover, many of these cases receive a false diagnosis of carcinoma, which could result in substantial psychological distress to patient.
Do you ever wonder what causes false positive result? Is it as a result of different type of screeners and slight preparation? Let's start by discussing the 2 types of screener that we have, cytotechnologies and pathologies. STAT claimed that even while pathologies had a lower rate of false positive, there was no difference between them. Consequently, the type of screener is not what leads to a false positive diagnosis. Then, how about type of preparation? We have 2 types, which are conventional and liquid-based method. Sinders found that morphologies of reparative changes seen in conventional and liquid-based smear show similarities and differences. As you can see here, the top picture 1A and 1B are from conventional smear, meanwhile the bottom one, 2A and 2B, are from liquid-based smear. Both types of preparation reveal flat sheet of cells arranged uniformly. Cells in conventional preparation display a flowing nuclear polarity, or we call it as streaming or school of fish, with conspicuous nucleoli. Meanwhile, the cells in liquid-based smear were more spherical, and as a result, the streaming was less noticeable. So is it because of these differences that causing the cytotechnologies to make mistake? The answer is no, because according to the most recent study, which was conducted during 2019, the studies by Sinders was constrained by a number of issues because it was carried out at the time when liquid-based preparation was still in their early stage. STAT conclude that different slight preparation methods are also not the cause of false positive. It is actually based on the skill and experiences of the cytotechnologies.
Let's take a break by answering this quiz. Which one is the reparative changes? Is it A or B? Yes, the answer is A, because the cell have 1-time to 2-time nuclear enlargement, smooth nuclear membrane, prominent nucleoli, fine chromatin, and abundant stress cytoplasm. Next, between these 2 pictures, which one is reparative changes? Is it A or B? Yes, the answer is B, because it has fine granular texture, pale chromatin, and famously cohesive.
In conclusion, we can conclude that regenerative is the part of reparative process of the cells, which the regeneration process of the cells usually occur when basal cells are replacing the injured or damaged cells. Apart from that, despite the switch from conventional smears to mostly liquid-based preparations, the present study does not show any increase in diagnostic performance of repair sites compared to the past studies. Hence, cytotechnologies must improve their skills so that the misclassification of reparative cells as high cell or carcinoma can be avoided.